In the East Village of New York, in this design firm on 9th Street, one man is trying to change the world.
Between stopping World War III, maybe saving the planet, helping our economic prosperity, those are pretty good reasons to save energy.
His name is Henri Giffard. He's a leading energy consultant who designs extremely efficient heating systems for buildings. And his next project will be literally and figuratively groundbreaking.
I'm pushing the industry forward. I'm making actual change. As an example, instead of saying, well, here we've got a plaque, or we've got some number rating or color rating, look at our county bills. We really do have a very, very energy efficient building, probably by far the most energy efficient building in North America, apartment house anyhow, and it'll be great. It's a new frontiers.
His self-taught expertise in energy efficiency sprouted nearly 30 years ago out of a desire to save money.
I bought my first apartment house when I was 20. I would sit with a book in front of my boiler reading. I'd see the fire, and it was like a stove 6 feet long, and I knew the gas meter was just spinning dollars right out of my pocket. And I'm trying to figure out how it all works. I took $100, got on my bicycle, went to Barnes & Noble. Figured I can solve a lot of problems that way. Started working on my heating systems for friends. Ended up becoming a lifelong passion, big specialty.
Despite his accomplishments in reducing energy use, Henry's buildings are not certified by the U.S. Green Building Council. That's because their rating system, called LEED for Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design, awards points for an array of different environmentally friendly attributes, including solar panels and proximity to public transportation. Over 14,000 projects in the U.S. are LEED certified, and it is the standard of green building in the U.S.
I guess it used to be, you know, if you didn't have a marble lobby, you weren't a Class A office building, you know. But now, one of the components of a Class A office building is LEED certification. You kind of have to have it.
However, it is a system that Giffard and others in this field see as problematic for its lack of focus on actual energy use.
There's a kind of fascination with the thing at the idea level, but there isn't a resolution, there isn't a deep understanding of how it actually behaves. And my experience with those buildings, with those high-profile green buildings, direct experience working hundreds of hours on those buildings, is that they don't really perform very well at the end of the day. People aren't very happy in them, and they use a lot of energy.
There is another certification system, though only a dozen or so buildings in the U.S. have met its requirements. It's called the Passive House Standard, and it began in Germany in 1990. Today, around 15,000 buildings worldwide have this certification. Passive houses rely on heavy insulation, air tightening, and good ventilation to slash energy usage by 90%.
Passive house means taking real responsibility. The engineer, the architect, the builder all have to work together to make the building better and different.
To prove how attainable such energy efficiency can be, Henry's design firm will break ground this fall for a project in Brooklyn they say will be the first apartment building in the U.S. to meet the stringent passive house standards. And it's not costing them anything extra.
And we like to have our buildings as models for taking away the excuse, well, it takes a long time to pay back the extra cost, well, we don't have the extra money, well, we don't use any extra money.
Henry even believes that these no-cost energy-saving building methods could have implications for national security.
What I'm worried about is that a few years from now, everybody's going to say, okay, we've done all these things green, lots of green buildings around, and look, we still don't have nearly enough energy. We have to have another war. That's what I'm worried about. If the truth be known, that we haven't really done much in terms of what we can actually do with existing technologies, then people are going to say, okay, let's start doing what we can do, what we need to do, instead of having a war, let's start saving energy.